Okay, in last class we discussed about the group function. We discussed that we are having the different group functions are there, min, max, sum, average and things like that. I want to do the practice on that one. Before that one I want to spool it. Lecture for morning students and what's that today? Set line size, set page size. Clear screen. Okay, now we discuss the group function. Just I am writing same over here. Select, I am using sum of group function that we are having the value of salary. Then I am using want to find the value of minimum salaries. Then we are having the maximum value of salary. Then we see that we want to find the average value. AVG. Now for these columns, if you want to use it over here, alias. For that one, for sum of salary, I want to use it over here, total. You can use it over here as and then use the double quotation marks, then you can, or simply you can use it over here. Minimums. Then for max salaries, you can use it over here. Maximum. And for average salary, we can use it over here. Average. And table is here from implies. Here it displays the value of total salaries, minimum salary, maximum salaries, and average salaries. Here the value of salary displayed 6441.1215. I want to remove all of these points. I want to display just a numeric values over here. So for that one, if you want to display just numeric values, so for that one, this one average function, we have to apply over here another function. This one is average. AVG is the group function that is used to display the average values. It display complete total average values, even it contain 10 character, 12 characters or any others after the points. Now I want to display it over here round. In the subject of mathematics, you people study the concept of the round. I mean, whenever we are having the numeric values are there and having the fraction, we can round them. Just I want to apply the round function for these ones. Let me say for average, round, and then this one become a nested function. What is the nested function? Function within inside another function, that is called nested function. So here I want to use the one function round that is considered as a nested function. Now when I apply this one, let's see what it happened over here. From implies, now it display the values over here 6441. Previously it display 0.111. now here it display just small, just integer values. We don't have the decimal portion of the value is here. Whenever we want to remove round the values, so for that one we can use it over here, the round function. Round function will arrange the value in the proper order and remove the fraction portion from that one number. Is it clear? Okay, the remaining all that we are having, every function, min function, maximum function, all of these are here. After that one, in last class we discussed about just the group function, min, max, disjunct keywords and null values, all of these. Now we want to use it over here, group by class. What is the concept of group by class, please? Let me see that we are having the data is here. Table is here, implied table. In implied table, we are having the different columns are there. When we want to apply the sum of function, when we want to know about sum value, what we did? We apply it over as sum and then salaries. It displays just single value. But if you want to know sum of the salary but department wise. We see that in department 10, what is the total salary? In department 20, what is the total salary? In department 30, what is the total salary? So if you want to know salary, total salary, but department wise. No. Here, where condition is used just to find only one. At one time, it will display only one record. Whenever we are using it over here, where condition, just for this one, if I want to apply it over here, where condition, okay, it will do it. Sum of the salary for one department. It will, where condition will display one or two department. Where we see that department ID 10, R department ID 20, R department ID 30, and this way we may be able to find that one. But as is, we don't know about all the department, what are the different departments are there. Right? So here if we are using it over here, where? Department ID. Let me say that's the 50. So it displays some of the salaries of department ID 50. Just department ID 50. Some of the salaries of minimum salary of department 50. Every salary of department ID 50. But I am interested by department ID that it must display each and every department. That what is the total salary of department ID 10. 20, 30, 40, 50 and all the others. Right? Yes. Okay. Then you have here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 different employees are there. And here is department ID 10, 10, 20, 20, let me see that 30, 30, 30, 30, 40, 40, 40. Right? Now here we see that we are having the salaries. 3,000, 2,000, 10,000, 1,000, 5,000, 8,000, 8,000, we said it's a 4,000, and then here we are having the department ID 40 is here, let me say that's 1,000, 1,500, and let me say that's 2,500. We want to know some of the salaries, but department wise. We say that what is sum of the salary for the department ID 10? What is the total salary of department ID 10, total salary of department ID 20, total salary of department ID 30, total salary of department ID 40. Display all of these values just in one query. So in such situation, we are having the concept of group by class. We are having the group by class. In group by class, we have to create the grouping of the data. In group by class, we have to perform the grouping of the data. Right? When we perform the grouping, we want to perform the grouping based on the department ID. Here, on the which one column we want to perform the grouping? We want to create the group by department IDs. Let me see this. We need a group, but according to the department ID. Right? We don't need to group by any other column. If you go for the grouping of department names, employee name, first name, last name, what will happen? Where it will find unique names, for that one it will display the value. If your name is repeated, for that one name, it will display just a single value. Let your name, Ali is there, again Ali and Ali. Ali name is three times is there. And we want to create a grouping by the first name. So for that one, it will display the same value over there. Now, what we see, group by class is used to create the grouping of the data by specific column values. Right? So let here we want to apply it over here. This one is clear? Okay. Select, I want to find some of the salaries, but department ID wise, right? And some of the salary of the specific department. Select what I have to write it over here. Department ID. Select department ID. And second one, I want to apply it over here. Sum. I want to know about sum of salary. And table is here. Table is here. We are having the employees. I want to know departments I want to know about the sum of the salary, but department ID wise. Now if you want to arrange this one, it will display an error message. It will display an error message. Error message is that you are not using the group by class. If we are not using the group by class and simply we are using select department ID in some of the cells, mean for that one, for which one point of view we have to mention that one, that from which one column we want to create the grouping, using which one column we are going to create the grouping. So here we when we see that select department ID sum of salary from employee, it will simply display an error message. Let's see what is that one error message. It display single group function, not a single group function, department ID. So for that one, what I told you, we have to use the group by class, use it. From which one column we are going to create the groupings? Using the department ID, we are creating the groupings, right? So here what we have to do, group by department ID. So mean it will create the grouping of the data, but with respect to the department ID, right? We must have mentioned it over here, the column names in the group by class by which we want to create the groupings. Okay, so for that one we have to write select department ID, sum of salaries from employees, and after that one, if here we want to create the grouping by specific department, then we must need to apply the group by class. Like we are having the data is there, you want to know that salary is there, you want to find the salaries of, let's say, like having university record is available, you want to know that salary with respect to the job ID, what is the total salaries of all the lecturers, lecturer, what is the total salaries of professors, what is the total salary of administrative staff, what is the total salary of clerical staff, and all others. So for that one, you have to create the grouping by the job ID. Here we want to know the total salary with respect to the department ID. That's why we have to use it over here, group by class. And which one column that we want to use it over here? No, here we are using the department ID. Now it displayed at in department ID 30, we are having the sum of salary, that is 25,900. In department ID 100, we are having the total salary is this one. 20, we are having this one. So mean it find the total salary with respect to the department wise. It displays the total salary with respect to the department wise. Sum of the salaries, but for that one, what we are having? With respect to the department wise. So here we are using the group by class. Group by class is used to identify the value of all the values, sum of the value, but with respect to the department ID. Is it clear? Now we want to apply it over here, the group by class, same, let's be having another column, job ID is there, we want to know according to the job ID what is the total salaries. Let here we, if we check it over here, select job ID, and then we are having the salary from, we are using it over a table is here employees, and we are using it order by, let me see, it's a job ID. It display that here we can see that FI accountant is here, second one is FI accountant, 4-5% are accountant are there. If you see it over here, ID programmers 1%, next 1%, third 1%, fourth person, different person are having the job ID, that's a IT programmer. Similarly, here what we are having, just check it out, PU clerk, then SC managers are there. We want to know the total salaries of these according to job ID. What is the total salaries of SC manager? What is the total salary of PU clerk? What is the total salaries of IT programmer? All the IT programmers. We want to find all of these in one query. So for that one, what we have to do? We have to write it over here. Select what job ID and sum of. Okay. Table is here.
Yes, from employees. Group by job ID.
And here we have to use group by
job ID.
Right? So in this way we may be able to find some of the salaries according to the group wise. Means by specific here the job ID. If we are not using here group by clause, it will display the error message. Is it clear? Concept is clear? Okay. Now here we see that sir. Select job ID. I want to apply it over here sum of salaries. I want minimum salaries, min of salaries. I want to find the max of salaries. And then I want to apply over here sum, min, max and also average salaries. And then average salaries. Right? And also you people can use it over here the LGs. You have to use it by yourself, right? Table is here from and which one group by class?
Job ID.
Group by which one column?
Job ID.
Yeah. Now it display the job ID. We are having AC manager. You will find only once AC manager. This it will display the sum of the salary, minimum salary, maximum salary, and average salary. Where we are having the job IDs manager. Similarly, MK managers, MK accountant, AT, SH clerk, and all the others. Is it clear? Now, here we are having the value of every cell you can find 3215.789494, like that ones. I want to round it, the specific precise it. So, for that one, before the AVG, use it over here, round function. What we have to use it over here instead of AVG and then salary. Before this one, use it over here.
Round.
This one round function will round the value and display the specified value. Is it clear?
Yes.
Okay, students. Now we want to find the total number of employees. So for that one, we have to write it over here, select, let I want to say according to department ID, I want to count him. Select department ID and then I want to count and say that's how many number of employees that are available and that one specific department, count steric. Count steric will use, it will count the number of rows according to each and every departments, right? You can use it over here, count employee ID, department ID, job ID, any other, you can use it over here. And table is here from
employees
and group by which one column that we want to create the grouping? Department ID. Now it says that we are having three different employees are there whose department ID is not mentioned. In department ID 30, we are having the total 7 different employees are there. In department 100, we are having the 6. In department 110, we are having the 2. In department 50, we are having the maximum number of employees. Those are 44 over here. Right? Yeah. So, mean whenever we want to apply to know about the specific department ID, for that one, we can use it over here, the count, and then group, we have to use the group by class. Yes.
Yeah.
Total number of employees that are available in the department ID 30 data.
7 rows, sir. 7 records.
Yes, that is 7 records means 7 employees are there.
Yeah.
7 records means 7 employees are there. Just you can use it everywhere. Count steric. Instead of steric, you can use employee ID. Then again, it will display the same record.
7 employees are there which have 30, ID of 30.
Department ID, whose department ID is 30. right? For this one we are not having any department ID, mean the value of the department ID when we are having the null is there, then for those we are having three employees whose department ID is not mentioned, right? That's why here you see that same department ID 10, we are having just one employees, 60 we are having the five employees. It find total according to each in every department ID and display the value over here. Please do the practice on it, then we have to go the one new concept. Now I want to do something wrong over here, right? To make something clear to you people, I am going to first do the right things wrong and then I will come on the right track. Okay, let I am using it over here. Please select, I am using it over here, department ID, and then I want to use the sum of salaries. Sum of salary table is here from employees, and after that one what we are using, group by class, group by, I want to use it over here the job ID. What will be happened? It will display an error message that here we are using the department ID, but here we, I am going to use it over here the job ID. It display not a group by expressions, we are department ID is not available over here. That here what we are using it over here department ID, but in group by class we are using the department ID. What the column that we want to use it over here, the column that we want to use upper here, that must be available, that same column must be there, same column must be there. Okay, now I want to perform the group by class by two different columns. I want to apply group by class by two different columns. Let me see that it may be possible in the one department. In one department, let we are having department ID 10 is there. In 10 department, we are having the different job IDs are also there. In department 10, we see that some managers are there and clerk are also there. Right? I want to know that in department 10, total salaries of clerk as well as in department 10, total salary of managers. Right? Similarly, in department ID 20, total salary of clerk and managers. Right? So, mean here we want to make it more complex, little complex. We see that previously we see that in department 10, we are having total salary as this one. But now what we want? We want to display the value of the salaries, total salary, in department 10 with respect to also the job ID. That in department 10 we see that the VIA clerk, their salary is, we see that some, their total salary is their 15,000, right? And then we see that in department ID 10, we are having the manager, their total salary is 12,000, right? In department 10, job ID is clerk, their total salary is 15,000. In department 10, job ID is manager, their total salary is this one. How we may be able to find that one? So for that one, just I want to apply it over here. First we want to check it out, right? Select department ID, and then I want to use it over here the job ID, and then I want to use it over here salary table is here from employees, and then I want to use it over here order by, order by first I want to use it over here department ID, and then I want to use it over here the job ID. Both of these column I want to create the job order by class. Now just check it out. Just here check it out, in department 50 we are having ST clerk are there. We want to know that in department ID 50 what is the salary of ST clerk. Then we want to know that what is the salaries of ST manager in also department 50, right? One department is there, two different job IDs are available in department tables. One department, but containing two different job ID. We see that we need to know about the salaries, but for that one, what we say? We need to salary, we see that department ID 50 for BRM. What is the salary of ST clerk? What is the total salary of ST clerk and department ID 50? Similarly, what is the total salary of N department 50? What is the salary of ST?
Manager.
So here in group by clerk, we have to use the two different columns. Here in group by clerk, we have to use the two different columns. One column, that is a department ID. Second one column, that is a job ID. So in group by clerk, we can use more than one columns. Is it clear?
Sir, how do you know sir, ST manager? Which one is this?
Yes.
Five ST manager is here.
So some of the salary, what will be? It will be five. Add all of the sum, 5,800, 6,500, 7,900, 8,200, and 8,000. It will some of the salaries of ST manager and department ID 50. What? We want to know total salaries by the department ID and then we are having the job ID. In job ID 50, we are having the different ST managers are there. So it will find the total salary of all the ST managers in department 50. Similarly, it will find the different ST clerk are there, so many ST clerk are there. Right? Some of the salaries of all the ST clerk. It will find from this one point to upper all of this one. ST clerk salary. What? Some of the salaries of all the ST clerk. So for that one, what we have to use it here? We see that job ID first, or we see the department ID. Second one is here we are having the job ID. First one is department ID, second one is job ID. And then what we want to know over here, sum of salaries. Department IDs and job IDs, then we have to use it over here, sum of salaries. Table is here from employees and group by which one column? Debt ID. And second one is job ID. We must have to mention it over here, both of these columns. If we mention one column and group by clause, it will display an error message, right? Because we want to create a grouping with respect to both of these columns. Like this one, that whenever we are having the ST manager is there, find the total salary of ST manager. Whenever we are having the ST clerk and department ID 50, find the total salary for the ST clerk and department ID 50. Clear? What?
ST manager, there is 5 ST managers. Which one is this?
So what is the sum of the salary? Why we are using? Sum of the salary is used to find all the ST managers. Sum of salary.
Sum of salary.
Right? Whenever we are going to sum of the salary, so it will find with that what is the job ID ST manager is there. It will find that in department ID 50. Right? So it will find all of this one after having the ST manager is there. So it will find sum total of ST managers. Right? Where we are having the ST manager is there, it will find total of that one. Right? Similarly, where we are having the ST clerk is there, it will find the total of that one. Sum. We need to find the total. Add them all of the same is the that one. Not only one. Yes?
There will be duplicated.
Why?
ST manager.
There are 5 ST manager. 5 ST manager is there. But it will take it only once. ST manager. Just one. And add all of these values, where we have the estimated value. What we have is some of the why we have to find the aggregate value. That's just one. I'm using it up here, please. Job ID, and let me see that, sir. Then we are having ST manager. ST manager. ST manager. And ST manager. Again, one more ST manager. Now we are having ST clerk. ST clerk, ST, clerk. Is it clear? Yeah. That here we are having the regular salary is here. That is here, it's a 2000, 2000, 1000, and 5000. And then now again we are having, let me say, it's a 7000. Right? Now here we are having, let me say, it's a 3000, 1200, 2500. Now we want to apply some of the salaries. We want to apply the sum of the salary by job ID. What will be happened over here? It will, where we are in job ID, we have to grouping by group by the job ID. It will take, what is this ST manager, sorry. We are having the column is here, ST manager. 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5 ST manager are there. What it will do? We see that job ID. And what we are having, the sum of salaries. Right? And then from employees. And group by job ID. What will be the result over here? What will be the result over here? The result will be, it will add all of these five values. It will add these five values and it display their values. Right? It display that whenever we are having the ST manager is there, we are having job ID ST manager is there, it will add 2000 plus 2000, 4000, 5000, 10000 and plus this one also, 17000. It will display that ST manager is having the salary 17000. Right? Now, we are having ST clerk. What is the salary of that one? So, ST clerk, we are having 1, 2, 3 ST clerk are there. It will find the sum of all of these. So, we are having 3000 plus 25, 12, 4200 plus approximately 6700. It will display the total values over here. Although here we are having 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 values of ST managers are available. Right? Now, what we are having? This thing is just from one department, it's just job ID. If we want to go for two different columns, that we are having one column extra, we want to add it over here. Department ID. Now let's see. What will be the result of this one? Right? Let me say here we are having the department ID. 10 are we, okay, I'm using it over at 50, then here I want to use it over here, 40, then here I want to use it over here, 50, and 40. Right?
Yes.
Just focus on this one. Here what we say, we want to know some of the salaries with respect to department ID and the job ID. We see that in department 50, what are the different job IDs are there? In department ID 50. Yes. In department 50, we are having ST manager is there. Second one is ST clerk is there. In department ID 50. So it will display it over here. Debt ID and job ID. Department ID 50 is there. In department ID 50, we are having the job ID is here. One is ST clerk. Second one is department ID 50, we are having ST managers. Right? So mean it will find the sum of the salary of for department ID 50 with respect to the ST clerk and the sum of the salary and department ID for the ST manager. So what we are having manager is there. Here, in department ID 50, we are having the two different managers are there. Although these are the managers are there. ST manager, but department ID is here 40. It will not display the value over here. For that one, it will display 40 and ST manager. Right? So it will find some of the salaries for all of those employees who belong to department ID 50 having the job ID ST managers. Is it clear?
Yes.
So here it will 2000 plus 2000, it will find display the values that over here the 4000. Sum of the salaries? Right? No. Similarly, we are having the department ID 50, having the ST manager. Sorry, ST clerk and ST manager. Where is the clerk? In department ID, this one, you two are the clerk. So 3000 plus 1200, what we are having? 4200. Now we are having department ID, ST manager, VC date, that is a 4000. In department ID 40, ST manager, it will check that department ID 40 is there. This one is 40 is there and ST manager is there. Any department ID 40, what we are having?
3.
Any other is there? Okay, the next one is also there. 3 different employees are there. So what we are 1000 plus 5000 plus 7000. So what we are having? 6000, 13000. Here. And similarly, department ID 40, we are having the ST clerk. It will find the total salary, that is only one is here, 2500. Right? So here, we have to, whenever we have to apply the group by function, group by class, so we have to use the two different columns in group by class. What are those columns? One is job ID and department ID. If we miss one of them, then it will display the error message. Is it clear?
Yes.
I am doing it over here. Select what VC dates are department ID. Then we are having the job ID. Then we see there is a sum of salaries. And then from table is there employees and use it over here group by. But we see there is a group by department ID and so it will display it over here, just see it over here. That here we are having the which one department? Okay, department 30, just see. In department 30 we are having PU clerk is there. Sum of the salary for PU clerk, that is 13,900. And for MK manager, we are having the salary, that is in department 30, that is the 100. Similarly, in 100 department, we are having FI manager. The salary of that one is 12,000. And in department 100, FI accountant, that is 39,600. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Any confusion?
No, sir.
Time of
second. Yes, sir.
Okay.
Before we were confused, now clear, sir.
Sure.
Yes. Sir, please write the code. I want to know about the first name of employee.
Here, we are having the alias for the total salary, that is total. Now, table is here from employees. Now, we have to use it over here, group by. Then group by, we have to use it over here, department ID. We have to use it over here, department ID. When we are using it over here, the department ID only, what will be happened? It will display an error message. Why? Because here we are using only department ID, but in our column list, we are using two different columns. For that one, we want to apply the sum of the salary. Mean we need the total salary with respect to two column values, department ID and job ID. So if we are using in group by class only one column, it will display an error message. Right? One, that if the column is available in the column list, but we are not using it in the group by class, it will display an error message. What? Column is available in the column list, but that is not available in the group by class, it will display an error message. That here, the column job ID is available in the column list. Job ID is available in the column list, but this one column is not available in the group by class list. So it will display an error message. Is it clear?
Yes.
Concept is clear?
Yes.
What is the concept? That if column is available in the column list, but it is not available in the group by class list, then it will display an error message. So how we can remove it? We see that select department ID, job ID, sum of salaries, and using the alias total from employees and group by department ID, comma
job ID.
Job ID. Now it displays the values over here. Is it clear? So mean here it says that whenever we are having the department 50 is there. If in department 50 we are having more than one job are there. So according to those jobs, we have to arrange the groupings. Right? That within department we are going to arrange groupings. Within one department, we are going to create again groupings. That the person in one department 50, we are in clerk, create one group. Main group is here at department 50. In department 50, if we are having is clerk is there, they are having one group. If you are having manager is there, then they are having the second group. If you are having anyone else is there, what that one we are having the third group. So main is here that we are having department 50. In department 50, we are having if grouping is there, then perform that one. Right? Similarly, in department, let us say 60 is there. Again, in 60 we said it's a clerk. Clerk are here and clerk are here. Previously we were doing job ID, group by job ID. So it will display some of the salary by the job ID. Total salary of all the clerk, total salary of all the manager. But now, here we want to perform the grouping with respect to two different columns. One column is job ID, second is department ID. Right? Is it clear?
Sir, what is very useful?
Why it is very useful? Let we are taking any example of any organization. You are having the organization, you are the organization owners. Right? You want to know that in your organization, you are having a different department. Right? And you say that your organization, you are having the department ID 10, 20, 30, 14, 50. Right? You want to know that in department 10, how many clerk are there and how many manager are there? How many, let me say that accountant are there? Similarly, with in department 20, how many clerk, how many manager and how many accountant are there? So to know within one section, one department, we are going to again create the grouping of the data. Whenever we are going to create the grouping within the same section, so for that one, what we are having, we can use more than one column for the in group by clause. We can use more than one column in the group by clause. That's why we are using the group by clause. In group by clause, we are using more than one. Is it clear? So mean in practical scenario in any organization that we are having, this one department is here. We want to count that in department of computer science, how many lecturers are there? What is the total salary of lecturer in computer science? Total salary of assistant professor, total salary of professor, total salary of HOD. Same with the other department, BBA department, LLB department, with respect to job wise. We want to create the total with respect to the job wise of each and every department. So for that one we can use more than one column over here. Is it clear? Any confusion? Any problems? If anything is not clear? Any questions? Clear? Okay. Now we discussed it here, grouping by more than one column. We can perform the grouping of the data by more than one column, right? Now let here we can use it over here, group by department ID, group by job ID. Now if you want to use it over here, order by class, if you want to use it over here, order by class, use the order by class after the group by class. Order by class after the group by class. So after that one, what we have to do over here, first select department ID, job ID, sum of salaries from employees, group by department ID and job ID. After that one, what we have to do? Order by. And which one column? Let us say department ID, job ID, or some of sales there in others. Is it clear? So mean why we are using order by class? Yes. Order by class. Order by classes.
Same
English. Same very.
हम ऐसे ऐसे करते हैं क्योंकि हम चाहते हैं कि ऐसे कुछ नज़म दे सके और ग्रुप के हिसाब से
अरेंज कर सके. So for the properly arrangement of the data, we are using the order by class. Please study all of these things at home, right? Order by class is used to for the sorting purpose. to arrange the data in ascending order or descending order. Whenever we are using order by class, that is by default ascending order, right? Order by class is used to arrange the data in ascending order. By default in ascending order, right? And then if you want to make it arrange it in the descending order, then you have to use it over a DESC, right? Is it clear? Now, we want to use it over here. Select department ID, job ID, sum of salaries, total from employees, and group by department ID, job ID, and I want to use it over here. Order by?
Yeah.
What we are having? Department ID. Now, you can see it over here. That here we are having the department 10. Department 10, we are having AD assistant is here. In department 20, we are having the two different job ideas there. MK manager and MK representative. It finds total salaries of managers, all the managers in department 20 and total salaries of all the representatives in department 60. Same here, let's if we are having department 50. SH clerk and ST managers. We are having three different types of job ID are available in the department ID 50. So it arranges, find first what is the total salary of in department 50 of SH clerk. Total salaries of ST clerk in department 50 and the total salaries of ST manager in department 50. Is it clear?
Yes.
So mean here it properly arranged the values, right? Previously if you see that one, previously these values are not properly arranged in proper order, in ascending order or descending order. Now here these values are properly arranged. Is it clear?
Yes.
The concept of order by class is clear? You people want to do the practice on this one or should we go ahead?
Practice.
Now we want to discuss that illegal queries using group function. Few of them we already discussed. Okay. Select what we see that's a department ID. And then we want to count the value or count strategy you can use or any other column values. We are using the first names. You can use it over here. Steric, employee ID or any others, right? First names. It will count the value of the first name. And table is here from employees. If you want to execute this one, it will display the error message. Why? Because here we are having the group function. And with group function, we are using the one column. If we are having one column is there, that must be mentioned in the group by class. Is it clear?
Yes.
So here it displays the error message. So for that one, how we may be able to avoid this one? So here, use it over here.
Group by
and column names. Department ID. Now it displays the values over here. That in department ID 30, what we are having, values are here 100, 10,000, 40, 16, all of these, it will count the value of first names. Is it clear? Now, we are having another function is there. We want to count. Select department ID here and we want to use it over here again, job ID. And we want to use it over here, sum of salary. Right? Table is here from employees. And group by. We want to use it over here, job ID. Or department ID only. What will be happening over here?
Error.
Why?
Because
here in the column list, we are using the two different column. One is department ID, second one is job ID. Whenever we are using two column in the column list, all of those column must be available in the group by class. So when we want to execute, it display the error message that department ID, not a group by expression that is not available in the group by class. So for that one, how we can avoid them? So group by job ID, and then we are using it over here, department. It displays the value over here. Now that one error is removed. Is it clear? Now okay, Now we want to apply it over here. Any other operations? We want to know. Apply the group by clause. But where we want to apply the where condition? Where in group function? And with the group function, if we want to apply the where clause. Like where we want to use it here. Where minimum salary is greater than this one. Needed values are required values. So for that one, we are using the condition. If we are having the condition, right? Let we say that. Just I want to use it over here. Select. I want to use it over here. Department ID, and I want to find it over here. Minimum salary from employees. And then I want to use it over here, group by, and group by which one column? Department IT. Okay, here we are in space. Okay, now it displays the value over here. Please just focus on this one. Okay, here we are using department IT, minimum salary from the employee. So it display the minimum salaries of each and every department. Like in department 60, we are having minimum salary 4,200. In department 10, we are having minimum salary 4,400. 80, we are having 6,100. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
I mean, if you want to know that what is the max minimum salary in each and every department, so for that one, we can apply over a department ID and some minimum of salaries from employees group by department ID. If you want to know the maximum salaries, so for that one, what we have to do? Select department ID and max salary of each and every department. Okay?
Yes.
Now, here, if you want to know, then show me all of the department salaries. All of the department whose minimum salary, whose minimum salary is greater than, let me say, that's a 6,000. Show me all of those employees, all of those departments. If your end condition is there, show me all of those departments whose minimum salary is greater than 6,000. So what are those will be here from this one list? So you see that we have to apply the their class, right? And then in that class, what we have to use? Where?
Department ID is greater than 6,000.
No, we don't know. What is the minimum salary? Which is that their minimum salary is greater than 6,000. Their department ID is not greater than 6,000. For why? In department ID we are not having value 6,000. We are having the salary value is 6,000. But which is that their minimum salary? Show me the list of all of minimum salary of all of those department. We are having minimum salary, the department minimum salary is greater than 6,000. So it will not display this one record, that department ID 10, it will not display. It will not display the department ID 60. Why? Because the minimum salary of department 10 and 60, that is less than 6,000. We see that, show me all of those departments whose minimum salary is greater than 6,000. So here, department 10, minimum salary is less than 6,000, it will not display. Similarly, here we have 50, that is also not, it will not display. Here, what we are having? Any other?
30.
Like we are in 30, whose minimum salary is less than 6,000. Now, here we are having one option is before previously you were doing where class. What we were doing? Where class. And where class, what we say? Here, if we use where minimum. What is condition? Where minimum salary is greater than 6,000. If we apply this one, then select department ID minimum salary from employee, where minimum salary greater than 6,000, and then you want to use it as a group by clause, right? It will display the error message. Why? No, what's the reason behind that? Reason is that whenever we are having any condition is there, for any other condition, we are using the where clause. For any other condition, we are using the where clause. Where employee ID is this one. Where salary is greater than 10,000. Where job ID is this one. Right? We are using the where clause. But whenever we are having the group function is there. Whenever we are having the group function, with that group function, we may not be able to use the where clause. With the group function,
we may not be able to use the where clause. For that one, we have to use the
having clause. What? Which one clause we have to use? We have to use the having clause. Having clause is used to restrict the group by function value. Whenever we are having group by function values, our group function values. So to restrict the group function values, we have to use the where clause, having clause. And normal values, we have to use the where clause. Is it clear? So mean here, if you want to know that where minimum salary is greater than 6,000, so what we have to do is, if we are want to use it over a where clause in the group by group function, it will display error message. So whenever we want to use the group function in condition, for that one it is necessary that we must use having clause. Is it clear?
Both
are same. Although no difference. What is the difference? Whenever we want to restrict the group function, when we want to restrict the group function, then use the having. Whenever you want to restrict the other values, for that one you have to use the where. That is the main difference. Right?
Yes.
If you want to note this one point, note it with yourself. It's very important.
It's
we want to restrict the condition, any other condition, for that one we have to use the where clause. But if we want to restrict, if you want to restrict the group function, for that one we have to use the
having.
Is it clear?
Yes.
Now here we see that we are going to select department ID, minimum salary from employees, group by department ID. Same, what we say? Group by department ID. Okay. Just I want to use reuse it. Now, select department ID, minimum salary from employees, and if you want to use it over here, where?
No, it's coming.
Where? I want to use it over here, minimum salaries. Where minimum salary greater than 6,000. And then after that one, group by clause, group by department ID, it will display the error message. What's the reason behind that? Reason is that in group function, we may not be able to restrict the group function by the where clause. To restrict the group function, we have to use the concept of which one clause? Having min salary greater than 6,000. And now group by which one department? Just check it out. Now previously we were having, now here all of it display the minimum salaries of all the other departments, but where the minimum salary value is greater than 6,000. Is it clear? Questions? Here we discuss that whenever we want to restrict the group function, when we want to restrict the group function, to restrict the group function we have to use the having clause. So for that one, whenever we want to apply that one and to select the specific row, so for that one and having the group, using the group function, so for that one we have to apply the having clause. Right? Having, using the having clause, we may be able to identify that one. Right? Having maximum salary is this one, minimum salary is this one, having sum of salary greater than this one. So mean whenever we want to apply group function in condition, whenever we are having group function in condition, never ever use the where clause. Always use having clause whenever we are having group function in condition. Having sum of salary is greater than 13,000. Having any others? Okay, now we want to apply it over at the nested function. Right? Nested function. Like here, we are having one function is here. Previously we already discussed about few nested function. One is, what is the nested function that we already discussed? One, in this one class we discussed we are having average and then apply their round. Average and then round. Now, second one, We in the previous class we discussed NVL function. We count an NVL function, if you people remember, null value function. In the last class we discussed. Now we are having another function. We are average in maximum values, right? We want to apply it over here. Select. We say that we want to find the average value with respect to the department ID. Average salary. We want to apply the average salary from table is here. Employees, and we want to group it by we see that's the department ID. Now even here we are not using the department ID. Even we are not using the department ID. But if we are simply using it over here, select every salary from employees, it will display only one values. If we are not mentioning it over here the department ID, still we are going to apply it over a group by department ID. It will arrange it, but it will display more than one value. For all the other department, but we are having the different department are there, according to those department, it will display the values over here. Let's see how. It display here the different values over here of the average salary according to each and every department. For this one is department 10, this one 20, this one 30 and 40 and so on. Right? So here what had happened over here? Mean here we want to apply average salaries with respect to the department ID. But we are not mentioning it over here in the column list department ID. No problem will be there. Right? Even if simply we use it over here, select every salary from employees, and we are not using group by class, it will display just single values. Right? But if you want to group by department ID, so according to department ID, it will find the average of all of those values. Is it clear? Now, from this one value, all of the average values are available. I want to know that what is where we are having the maximum average. Find the maximum average value from all of this one. Which one is the maximum average? 1933.33. That is the maximum average. So for that one, what I have to do? First find average. What we have to do? First find average of salary. Please. Here we have to find the average of salary. Then after that one, apply over here. What we have to see is the maximum average salaries. This will find the average salary with respect to each and every department. Now it will find from all of these values maximum value. What is the maximum value? It will display just this one. Is it clear?
Yes.
So this one function is called function within a function. That is called nested function. Function within a function, that is called nested function. Here we want to use nested function. Let me say select average. So before average, what I want to use? Maximum average values, right? Maximum average of salaries, and table is here from how you may be able to know that 1933 from employee, and then group by that will be the result. Group by department ID. Here it display 1933.333. Right? Is it clear? Now, if you want to know, please, here if you want to know, this one is the maximum values, average values, maximum average is here. If you want to round it and display the value 1933, just only that one. What do you have to do?
Round.
Apply the round.
Round.
Before this one, max, apply the round, then max, then over here, third one function. Please do the practice on it. And also mention the round also.